Right. What else is going on? So eye contact, none, right? There was no handshake, like welcome, eye contact, nothing. Oh, excited to be here, let me introduce myself. It's hard. I share this with you because I guarantee you that you will be future managers hiring people that will come in and interview with you like this. And you've got to be honest with yourself. Do you want that person on your team? And I would hope the answer is not, because we're in hospitality and we're trying to give the best delivery of what we have to offer to our guests, right? So this guy's doing horribly. It's actually a painful video for me to watch. I've never been able to get through the whole thing, but I'm going to show you like another minute of it, right?
What are your strengths?
I'm really good at math and science. I'm really good in those subjects. I've gotten A's in all my math classes, and I think I've gotten like all A's and B's in my science classes. So, and I really like doing science stuff. I really enjoy that. So, I think those are my two big strengths. And I'm also really good with people. My interpersonal skills are good. I'm good at talking to people. So.
And on the flip side, what are some of your weaknesses?
My biggest weakness is that I'm a big workaholic. I have to be working all the time, on the evenings and even on the weekends. Like, I just don't take time off. So, I'd say my biggest weakness is just that I'm a workaholic. And I'm always working.
All right, I can't do it. All right, so I'm stopping. With his strengths and weaknesses, those are two basic kind of questions you're going to get. He didn't have a strong delivery. It's almost like he wasn't expecting it. He was like, they're going to ask you this question. You've got to be prepared. And just so you know, that weakness response is the most cliche response people give. Everyone's like, I work too much. Gave a personal reveal as to why I didn't have one. I was a victim of a violent crime as a child, and I was always afraid of that person finding me as an adult. And so I was very private on social media. And I told the people who hired me, I said, but I can assure you that if accepted into this position, I will establish a profile and work through that challenge. And I could probably do it within like the first 6 months or so. And then when I got the job, I did just that, right? Now, offering that little bit of personal, perspective on my life, what do you think that made, what do you think that did for the people who are interviewing me? I wasn't just gonna say exactly what they wanted to hear, right? I wasn't going for that. I was going for the honest answer. And so, literally later on, I had feedback on that answer. When I followed up, they were like, we really appreciate your honesty. I was like, right? So it helped me to be honest. Now, there is a thing of being too honest, right? I'm not gonna go into what happened. I don't need to go to the gory details of the crime, right? I just need to paint the picture and move on and show how I'm gonna overcome that weakness, right? And then keep my word when I'm in the job. So you have to keep your word about it. It's not just telling them a sob story, because I wasn't trying to do that. I was like, I know this is an actual weakness, because I did my research and I saw that most of the other people in that department already had a LinkedIn profile. I was like, I don't have one. I did my homework. I shared my weakness, but then I overcame it. So I'm just being really honest with you. The next video I'm gonna show you guys, he does a little bit better, and I say a little bit. It's not perfect, okay? And that's why I titled this Better But Not Perfect. So I want you to pay attention when you watch this one. What is he doing better or differently? That's good. But then also keep in mind, what could he continue to improve?
To manage manage 5 employees, create schedules, track inventory. So all those things really demanded good organizational skills. Also, maintaining databases, keeping accurate records, all while going to school full time, also demanded organizational skills. So I think those two things would be my strengths: my close attention to detail and my strong organizational skills.
Okay. On the flip side, what are some of your weaknesses?
I would say that the biggest weakness in regards to this position is the fact that I've never worked in a vet clinic before. So were I to be hired, I would have to learn the different roles of the vet clinic, the roles of the employees, and kind of how everyone works together in order to make the clinic run properly. However, I am a quick learner, and I also think I have a number of experiences that really have prepared me for this type of job. As I mentioned, I did job shadowing with a livestock veterinarian, so I already have some experience with veterinary medical procedures, with the medications and a few techniques. My work as a sanitary technician helped prepare me for working in a sterilized medical environment. And my work as a manager at Target showed me how teams work together and how specialized roles can come together to accomplish a group goal. So while if I were hired, I would have a little bit of learning to do, I also think that I have a number of positions that have really helped prepare me for this type of position.
What did you catch in that response to the weaknesses?